ग्रीटिंग्स। यूनिट नंबर 6, लेक्चर नंबर 3। लास्ट लेक्चर वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट एक्सपेंशन कर्व। द फर्स्ट एक्सपेंशन कर्व इज कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर प्रोसेस वेयर वैल्यू ऑफ एन इज इक्वल टू 0। दिस इज स्ट्रेट लाइन परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्रेशर लाइन। सेकेंड कर्व इज आइस एक्सपेंशन कर्व फॉर आइसोथर्मल प्रोसेस वेयर वैल्यू ऑफ एन इज इक्वल टू 1। थर्ड कर्व फॉर पॉलीट्रॉपिक प्रोसेस वेयर वैल्यू ऑफ एन lies between 1 and gamma. Fourth expansion curve is for isentropic process or the adiabatic process where value of n is equal to gamma. Fifth expansion curve is for polytropic process again where value of n is greater than gamma. Last expansion curve is a straight line for constant volume process where value of n is equal to infinity. Now let us draw the PV diagram. Let us understand the PV diagram for reciprocating compressor. Here we are considering three processes: polytropic process, isothermal process, and anisotropic process. Let us look at the compression curve again. For isothermal compression curve, the isothermal compression curve is below the polytropic curve, and anisentropic compression curve is above the polytropic curve. Here process. Consider a PV diagram. The start of compression is at high pressure, high volume and low pressure. Process 1-2-2 is a compression. 1-2-2 is a polytropic compression where value of n lies between 1 and gamma. Then 2-2-3 is a delivery process. 4-2-1 is a suction process. Now consider isothermal compression. Process 1-2-2 is a isothermal compression. Now consider isentropic compression. Process 1-2-2' is isentropic compression. Now area under the curve 1-2-3-4 is a minimum. It means we can conclude that the compressor requires a minimum work when the process is isothermal. The work done for isothermal process represented by the area under the curve 1-2-3-4. Work done for polytropic process represented by the curve under the process 1-2-3-4, and the work done for isentropic process represented by area under the curve 1-2-3-4. From the diagram, we can say that the area under the curve is a minimum for isothermal process. Therefore, work done for isothermal process is less than polytropic process. And work done for polytropic process is less than isentropic process. Therefore, isothermal efficiency is the ratio of isothermal work to the polytropic work. And the polytropic efficiency and isentropic efficiency is the ratio of polytropic work to the isentropic work. Now let us derive the equation for work done for non-flow process. First understand what is non-flow process. The process in which working substance does not leave the system boundary. Such processes are called as non-flow process. The process takes place in the closed cycle or the closed system is called as a non-flow process. In closed system, working substance does not cross the boundary.